हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 9 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स, चैप्टर 11 कंस्ट्रक्शन। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 5। फ्रॉम दिस लेक्चर वी विल सीक सम कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स। इट इज एक्सरसाइज 11.2। वी विल स्टार्ट हियर इन विच वी विल ड्रॉ द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ सम ट्रायंगल्स। द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज कंस्ट्रक्ट ट्रायंगल एबीसी इन विच बीसी इक्वल टू 7 सेंटीमीटर, एंगल बी इक्वल टू 75 डिग्री एंड ए बी प्लस ए सी इक्वल टू 13 सेंटीमीटर। दिस इज गिवन। सो विल नोट डाउन द गिवन थिंग फर्स्ट इन द ट्राइंगल इज बी सी इक्वल टू 7 सेंटीमीटर, एंगल बी इक्वल टू 75 डिग्री एंड ए बी प्लस ए सी इक्वल टू 13 सेंटीमीटर। टू कंस्ट्रक्ट हियर, आवर एम टू कंस्ट्रक्ट हियर अ ट्राइंगल ए बी सी विद द गिवन मेजर्स, विद द गिवन मेजर्स दैट इज बी सी इक्वल टू 7 सेंटीमीटर, एंगल बी 75 एंड ए बी प्लस ए सी इक्वल टू 13 सेंटीमीटर। To draw this construction first, we will draw the rough figure over here. So from rough figure, if you understand that we have to draw BC first, and this BC must be of length 7 centimeter. It is given, that's why. Here I am not measuring, here I am just drawing the rough figure. So I am not drawing it by measure, just I am getting the idea how to draw this construction over here. The real construction will draw here in this space. Yes, just we are getting the idea what the steps we have to make. So first we will BC draw of 7 cm and angle B we will draw the 75 degree angle making ray BX we will make of 75 degree making angle, and then on this ray BX we will get a point A such a way that this AB plus AC makes sum of AB plus AC makes 13 cm, right? So to get its real construction, now we will start the steps and we will draw the construction related to this. Okay, so very first step you can understand is to make the base of 7 cm we have, that we will draw first. From this, using scale and pencil, draw a ray BC such that it is 7 cm. So this is 7 cm I am drawing. BC of 7 cm. Right? Now on angle B, 75 degree we need. Angle B, 75 degree we need. How to draw all type of angles? We have seen from the last lecture. In the last lecture we have seen in exercise 11.1. To draw 75 degree, what to do? We take the rounder point on B, that is center as B, and take some arbitrary radius this way and draw a big arc intersecting BC at some point this way. So this point is 0 degree point, you know. On 0 degree point on the first arc, if you put our rounder on the same radius, this way I will draw the 60 degree angle point here, it will get, we will know. And from 60 to one more arc, if I draw here on the same arc, first arc, 120 degree angle you get. And between 60 and 120, 90 degree we will get here. From 60 degree point only, here we will draw one arc. And from 120 degree point, intersect that previously drawn arc, you will get 90 degree point there. If you join this with the B, on B you will get 90 degree angle, right? This way the broken line, I am drawing this to get the point. So this is the 0 degree point on the first arc we have, 60 degree point here we have, 90 degree point here we have, 120 degree here we have. Our aim is to draw 75 degree angle, right? 75 degree angle is between 60 degree point and 90 degree point, you know. So our aim will be to draw the bisector of 60 and 90, so that in between that we will get 75 degree. So take the center as 60 degree point here, means rounder point here. Take some arbitrary radius, this much I am taking, and draw an arc from 60 degree point. It is drawn. Now put your rounder on 90 degree point. Intersect the previously drawn arc here. This point, passing a ray starting from B to passing through this point will give 75 degree angle, you know, because it is passing between 60 and 90, so it will give 75 degree angle. So this is the second step also we have done. BC 7 centimeter we have done first step, angle B 75 degree we have drawn. Now the remaining AB plus AC equal to 13 centimeter. Using that step, what to do with that 13 centimeter? We will take the center as B and radius as this 13 centimeter. Whatever the sum given, that much of radius we will take. So radius you take 13 centimeter. This is the big radius we have to take carefully. So for all 13 centimeter length I have to take. This way 13 centimeter is taken. Now put your rounder on B and this 13 centimeter ray, we intersect the previously drawn arc BX. It is intersecting on this point. We will say this ray, which is making 75 degree, as BX ray. And on BX ray, wherever this new arc, which is from the center B and the radius 30 centimeter drawn and intersecting the ray BX at this point, say this point as D. Now join BD, DC. Join DC. Joined. Now next step is to draw the perpendicular bisector of this DC. DC we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of this. How to draw perpendicular bisector of line segment, that we have seen in last lectures. We have to take our rounder point on any of the point of this line segment. If we start with the C point, I am taking the center as C, that is for rounder point on C. Then how much radius I have to take? More than half of DC. You know, more than half of DC radius I will take. This much is, you know, you can understand this is more than half. Okay. More than half length is taken. Now draw the arcs on both the side of this DC. This side, left side and right side, both the side we have to draw arc, taking the center as C and radius as more than half of DC. Draw both the side of DC one arc, this side and this side. Now next is, take your rounder point on D, that is center as D, and the previous radius only, don't change the radius, more than half DC that was taken, and intersect the previously drawn both the side arc from D now. So these are intersecting here and here. Join these two intersection points. These two intersection points, you join it and make a line. This is called perpendicular bisector of DC you have drawn. DC is perpendicular bisector you have drawn. This perpendicular bisector of DC, wherever it intersects BX, this point is that. Say this point as A. And now join A to C, that is join AC. This way the triangle ABC you have, that is our required triangle, in which BC is 7 centimeter, you know, we have constructed such a way. Angle B 75 degree, that also you can understand it is 75 degree. The question is how it becomes AB plus AC 13 centimeter. AB plus AC, how it becomes 13 centimeter only? So as you know, this length B to D is 13 centimeter. We have drawn like that only the arc. In that BA is the same, on the same path it is this part. The remaining AD of this BD, the remaining this part AD is shifted on C. This way, by drawing the bisector of DC, shifted on D, on this side C. So this is the perpendicular bisector. So AD equals to AC, you know, you can understand AD equals to AC. If BA plus AD is 13, therefore BA plus AC will also be 13, because AD and AC are same. And this part is common, this part is common in both, and these are the equal length. If BA plus AD gives 13, so BA plus AC will also give 13. So that way we have verified also. This way the construction is over. We look the steps also here. The construct BC says that BC go to 7 cm, very first step we have drawn. Then construct ray BX, ray BX we have drawn such that angle XBC equals to 75 degree. Now taking the center as B and the radius 13 cm, draw an arc to intersect the ray BX at D. We have taken B as center, 13 cm radius, drawn an arc on BX, it is intersecting D at ray BX at D point. Then join DC, we have joined DC. Construct perpendicular bisector of DC. This is the perpendicular bisector of DC we have drawn, which is intersecting ray BX at A. And then join AC, we have joined AC. And so that triangle ABC is required triangle constructed. So this way, the whole triangle ABC is constructed using these steps with the given measures. Thank you.